much, but I'm glad, cause they feed me the fuel that I need for the fire to burn. And it's burning, and I have returned, and I am whatever you say I am. If I wasn't, then why would I say I am?
Hey guys, love and hugs, love you guys, you're the best. Please donate to my Patreon.
Okay, seriously. So today we've got Tori Mary on the channel.
On the channel.
And we're just going to talk about her cycling adventure, cycling life, how she got into the whole sport and how she's benefited, how it's changed her life. So when did you get into cycling? You got, I think it was last year?
Yeah, last year December. Oh, maybe end of November, well, beginning of December.
End of, like, beginning of December.
Yeah. It was good fun. Really glad I got into it. Something everyone should do.
Yeah, and I remember Holly said you were still riding with fucking shoes, right?
Yeah, I got clip-ins in January this year.
Yeah,
she like did 2017.
You did like 150k riding in your shoes.
My first week of cycling, Holly's like, bam, let's just do a 150k cycle. I was like, yeah, why not? That night, I remember I came home and like I could not even feed myself. I was so tired. Falling asleep at the dinner table, and I just fell asleep, and then I woke up again starving in the night, so I had to eat, and oh, it was a workout. It was hard.
Sounds good. And you guys hooked up after that or before that?
My memory. I think afterwards. don't hold me on that.
No, the reason I'm asking is because I think like the cycling is a good way to date someone else.
Well, because you're just riding with someone for so long and you just can talk about anything, and like you're just together in the middle of nowhere and you just get chatting.
Sounds like a good first date, eh?
Yeah, it is a good first date.
150 k's of normal shoes, there you go. That's how you date someone, eh?
That's good.
Yeah,
well, at least you know now I can use clip-ins and it's easier.
So what have you learned, Zach?
With cycling?
Yeah, in the last 7 months.
What
are the best tips you can give?
Well, if you're going to start cycling, if you're like a beginner, if you're a girl and your boyfriend's trying to get you into it, make sure he does it so it's enjoyable for you, and don't make him push you too hard. And like, just do with what you're comfortable at, because you don't want to when you're first starting, just bang out TTs and absolutely hate it. Because TTs are hard, and like, you want to enjoy the experience. So first, maybe just go for rides to the beach, go get breakfast on your bike, just commute around so you get safe and like you know how to go through the traffic and enjoy the whole experience. But I've now learned, like I'm learning more like how to hold the wheel and just push myself and like just switch on my brain straight away, not like only sometimes. Like I need to get that whole mental state just when I'm cycling, just that I'm cycling, nothing else matters. Yeah, I think you learn a lot about your body as well, and like that you need just so much fuel, because if you want to go hard, you need to eat so much, otherwise you just bonk and you just can't do it.
Sugar water for the win, eh?
Yeah, sugar water for the win. It's good. It's good on the bike because it doesn't bloat you, it doesn't make you feel sick, and you can just sip it when you need.
Yeah, you don't have to reach for your pocket, get something out, and just sip and go.
It's good.
And you haven't done a TT in ages, eh?
No, probably like a month or so, I don't even know. It's bad. I think though, because like June and July, there was so much like competitive people and like everyone was wanting to get better. So you just had that stimulus that you wanted to do it. But now it's a bit quieter and you're kind of just in that chill out mood.
Yeah, she does fuck all the intensity. But even today, we're like going up the door and she had the stimulation of having Goose next to her, and they were just fucking
aggressive. Yeah, that was good training.
I looked down on my car meter, I'm like, Goose doesn't even do this in the 40 minute TT up the door, and I'm like, man, this is crazy.
Yeah.
Like, the chicks just have that mental stimulation, they go next level.
I think it's good training.
So it's definitely mind over matter.
Yeah.
80% psychology, 20% mechanics.
Yeah, I think so.
Just proved that again today.
And it's all just good fun at the end of the day.
Yeah. Like, it's a lot more fun if you're racing someone. Like,
yeah.
Even if you're going to plan to race, you're just like, you have this bitch next to you and you're just like, fuck bitch, I'm going to drop
it. Don't want to be dropped.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's good. It's good for training as well, because that's another like way to make it fun. Just have someone else similar fitness levels and just race each other. So, like, and like every day you might not be at your, like, you might not be feeling your best, and who cares if you don't get a good time? It's just, you're still training. Like, if you're feeling like you're pushing a fuck pillow, like you're feeling it, that's still good training. Even if your time's worse, like you can't always just be set on that time getting lower and lower.
Yeah, as long as you feel like giving up, it's hard enough.
Yeah, feel like giving up big time. Start feeling your legs and they start tingling.
What is your routine for the last month on the bike?
On the bike? Well, maybe I probably do a little bit less than 200 k's a week, and most mornings we've got the doy. I don't think, the last month, I don't think I've ridden anything else other than the doy. When did we do Samong? Was that a month ago or more?
Yeah, it was more than a month ago.
I've only ridden the doy in the last month. So yeah, just get up in the morning, have some sugar, do a poo.
And you haven't had any intensity in the month, just like sitting in people's wheels.
Yeah, I mean, if some people, like my training program, because I don't do intervals or anything, I train by saying if someone wants to pass me, then I have to pass them again or get on their wheel.
Yeah, luckily after doing this, a lot of people that are always a little bit faster than you.
Yeah.
Especially if you're a girl.
Yeah. Well, not really, not in Thailand. Because I'm really like
then all the cards are dropping too, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, looks like you're doing really well there. Eh?
It's good fun, I love it. And with all like you guys as well, it's so good and it just makes everything. Like you learn so much cycling with other people and get such good friendships and everyone's so like-minded. It's good fun. It's good.
Okay, I like it. Thanks for being on the show.
On the show. On the show. Four bands will. Thank you.